Alert from Google Chrome. New from this Tris scan bait.
Have you heard about the lonesome loser? Beaten by the queen of hearts every time. Have you heard about the lonesome loser? He's a loser, but he still keeps on trying.
Number 4, number 1.
Okay.
I got it. Yeah. So let me go ahead and read out the legal charges against your name. I would request you not to interrupt in between while I'm reading your state information. You will be given a fair chance if you had any questions, all right?
Well, I thought you're just notifying me that someone took my social security number. Why are there charges against me?
Yeah, I'll read out the case charges right now with yourself because there are so many our citizens that they don't know about other criminals are using their social security number.
Okay, so these are the charges that you're going to be filing against the person who took my social security number?
Yeah, right now we don't know that you are the criminal or someone else is the criminal. The only reason that we gave you a phone call that we found that your bank contains genuine records and your social have no other complaints in the past. Because of this, the Social Security Department has provided you this phone call.
Well,
you're getting me?
If I were the criminal, why would I be calling Social Security? This is my ID. This is me you're talking to. You verified it, right?
Yeah. So let me read out the charges.
Okay.
And after that, I'll transfer. Yeah. So your social has been found suspicious for fraudulent activities in the state of Texas. Have you ever traveled to the state of Texas before?
Texas, no.
Because we are taking this issue to the FBI headquarters as we are having strong evidence that are enough to prove you guilty inside a courthouse. This investigation started when we found an abandoned car on the south border of Texas, and the car contained some blood and drug residues inside it. After investigation, we found that the car was rented on your name and personal social information. There are two addresses linked with the title of the vehicle. The address in the city of Rowlett was read by the U.S. Marshal, but unfortunately, there was no one inside the residence. But we have recovered 22 pounds of cocaine, which is an abusive drug, and some documentation from financial institutes such as Chase Bank, Bank of America, and U.S. Bank.
Wait.
All this
you're saying that there's 22 pounds of coke in the car?
No. In the city of Rowlett, there was a residence. You know, there was a house, and after the U.S. Marshals, gone there, they have recovered 22 pounds of cocaine. This address was linked to that car that we have found in the south border of Texas.
Okay.
Yeah. And all that paperwork has your name on it, and thousands of dollars has been wired from this bank account locally and internationally, which totally seems suspicious to us. So we as the Social Security Administration of State of Texas has filed case against you for drug trafficking and as well as money laundering. So right now, in this regard, we have also checked your past record and we have found that your banking contains genuine records and your social have no other complaints in the past. This is the only reason we tried to reach you before you face any legal consequences. So if you are agree to help the Department of Treasury and the case, then only you can put your case and warrant on hold to find the real culprit who used your personal information to avoid these fraudulent activities. So right now, what's your intention? This was the cover page of your case file that I read it for you. So right now, what's your intention? You want to go to the courthouse and fight this case into the against the Social Security Administration of State of Texas, or you want to help us to find, if you are not the criminal, you want to help us to find the real culprit. What's your intention right now, man?
Well, I'm not admitting to anything because I didn't, you know, if you're telling me someone stole my identity to rent a car And then the address in the car was, they had, what'd you say, the U.S. Marshal found 22 pounds of coke? Really?
Yeah.
Do I need...
Yeah, there was... Yes.
Go ahead.
There were two addresses left by the address of vehicle. You know, on that vehicle, two addresses were left.
What addresses were those?
Address,
what addresses were those?
Yeah, one address is in the south border of Texas and the place that we found the car, and the second address is in the city of Rowlett that was raided by the U.S. Marshals, and we have found and we have recovered 22 pounds of cocaine from there.
What was the name of the city? Could you spell it out for me?
Rowlett. R-O-U-L-E-T-T-E.
Rowlett. Do I need to call the police all down there? And I think it's Roulette, but do I need to call them?
No, if you want to help us to find the real culprit, if you are not the criminal, then I'll transfer your call to my senior supervisor and he will help you to solve this problem. And he'll help you to, and he will give you more information. Then if you want to, if you want to fight this case into the courthouse, then you can hang up this call, and after that, you can wait for the phone call from 119.
119, what's that?
Police number, 119. It's police, local police number. When they call you, can't, by in 119.
Uh-huh. Well, you know, I'm the innocent party here, so... If someone has taken my social security number, I need to get to the bottom of it.
Okay, then I'll transfer your call to my senior supervisor, and he will give you more information about this case, and also he will help you how to solve this problem, all right?
All right. Thank you.
Yeah, because right now we have an issued arrest warrant under your name, and right now you have to... you have to hold that arrest warrant. Otherwise, within 1 hour, maybe you will receive a call from 119. Then thank you very much. Stay online. Stay connected. I'll transfer your call to my senior supervisor, and he will help you to resolve this problem. All right?
All right. Thank you, Mr. Martin.
Have a nice day.
Thank you for holding the line. Your call has been transferred to the Drug and Enforcement Department. How can I help you?
Well, I don't know. I was transferred to you as a senior supervisor, so what can you tell me about my social security number being hacked?
Okay, but right now you cannot tell me that it has been hacked. So can you prove yourself that you didn't choose it before? I want to ask you that you have never been in Texas before.
No, I've never been in Texas. That's a long way from Washington.
So you're in Washington?
Yeah. Aren't you? That's the phone number I dialed. Aren't you in Washington too?
See, this is the state of Texas, right? You know, this investigation started when we found an abandoned car on the south border of the Texas. And, you know, that car contains some blood and drug residues inside it. Hence, after the investigation, we found that the car was registered on your name and your social security information. And, you know, there are two addresses linked with the title of the vehicle. And the address in the city of the Rowlett was raided by the U.S. Marshal, but unfortunately, there was no one inside the residence. But we have recovered 22 pounds of cocaine, which is an abusive drug. And... you know, some documentation from financial institutes such as Chase Bank, Bank of America, and U.S. Bank. And all of this paperwork has your name on it, and thousands of dollars has been wired from this bank account, locally and internationally, which totally seems suspicious to us. So we, as in Social Security Administration of the State of Texas, has filed a case against you for the drug trafficking and as well as money laundering. Now, do you have any questions regarding this case and your fraudulent activities?
Okay, well, first of all, I'd like to know what your name is.
Yeah, my name is Frank Wilson with a badge ID number of GS5368.
Frank Wilson?
Correct.
And what's your badge number again?
That's G as in George.
Yeah.
S as in Sam. 5368.
Okay. Now, it's been a very long time since I've rented a car, but I wasn't aware that to rent a car nowadays you need a social security number. Is that right?
What do you mean by that? So you're not giving them your social security number?
Well,
when you're going to rent a car?
Yeah, you don't need to. Though, like I said, it's been a long time since I've rented a car, but they don't ask for a social security number. They just ask for a credit card and your driver's license.
No, it's not like that. You know, right now, I can see that that car was rented on your name and also on your social security number.
But that's what I'm saying. When you rent a car, you don't give them the social security number, you banchoed scammer.
What do you mean, motherfucker?
What do you mean? You're just a loser. Why do you have to steal from
you're
me?
You're like a piece of shit, motherfucker.
You're a banchoed.
You know
you're a banchoed.
You are a motherfucker. You know that, son of a bitch?
Is your wife
you
a...
You want to suck my dick,
is your wife a... No, I don't want to suck your
dick.
No.
You can do that.
No,
do that.
I can't suck your dick because
just
you
do
have
that.
A chutia.
You, do
you don't have a lund. No,
mother.
Randy Kabacha, don't give me that crap.
Go, you are a piece of shit, you know that?
You're such a loser.
You're a loser.
Yeah? Why do you say that? I'm not the one stealing from people.
None of your business.
What do you mean?
None of your business.
You're just
mind your business.
You're just a little Bihari boy, aren't you? You're a beggar.
Just shut the fuck up.
You fucker.
I'm really tired of
you benchoed fucker.
Just go and suck someone else.
You're You know,
my dick is not for you. Just suck someone else,
it's,
right?
You know why? Because you don't have a lun, you have a chutia.
I'm not married.
Thank God.
You piece of shit.
Uh-huh. Is that all you got?
Yeah.
You're such a loser, though. How come? Why do you have to scam?
No, I have already told you that. None of your business.
No.
Mind your business.
You don't have a family to support. You don't have a wife. You don't have any kids. Thank
None
God.
None of your business. I'm telling you that I'm not married. I don't want to marry.
Well, how much money did you make today, you scammer?
Today, like $20,000.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You won?
You're a null.
Can I buy you?
You're a null of yuck, aren't you?
I can buy you.
You're a null of yuck, aren't you?
I can buy you.
You
can't. I can buy your family.
You can't. You don't
you
know
can
where
buy
I am.
Family.
No.
I can buy your family, motherfucker.
Yeah. This Queen of Hearts beats you
so
every time.
You.
Yeah, don't give me
you
that bullshit. Yeah, you're
you
a fucker.
Fuck
you're rascal.
A piece of shit.
You
that joke, yes.
You're Ben Colodi. Ben Colodi.
Go and fuck yourself. What is that?
Yeah, you don't know.
What is that? I really don't know. What is that?
Where are you calling from? Nagaland? Are you Naga?
What's that?
Are you from Nagaland?
What is that? I'm from U.S., from New York.
You are not.
I am.
Are you from Noida?
I'm from New York, New York. You know that New York?
What city?
You don't know.
What city?
Which city of what?
What
Shall
city?
I tell you my address? You will come there?
What
you will suck my dick there?
What city, in New York?
You will suck my dick there?
Yeah, I'll do it.
You will do that?
What's,
how old are you?
What city? I'm old
how
enough.
Old are you?
I'm old enough.
Oh, then I'm not going to do that with you.
What city are you? Oh, you only want little goats?
Have you heard about the lonesome loser? Beaten by the Queen of Hearts every time. Have you heard about the lonesome loser? He's a loser, but he still keeps on trying. Sit down, take a look at yourself.